course, now that it's after midnight, it still requires 71 votes. We did our job in that regard, but we'll have to now sit down and see if we can get the cooperation of this House Republicans as well as the Senate Republicans.
Governor Quinn said that maybe some lawmakers just want to have a no vote on the record for the tax act. Why is that?
Well, I obviously some people, because of their districts, they feel like they cannot vote for a tax increase. It's always been easier for the Senate because we have four-year terms, and some people, the next time they're going to run, it's in a district that hasn't even been drawn yet. We do have more Democrats in the Senate as well, but so I can understand where we could have, it would have been easier for us to pass a bill than the House. But now we're going to need the cooperation of Tom Cross. Tom Cross is going to have to vote for an income tax now, because there has to be at least one Republican in the House vote for it. It's going to have to be Tom Cross. So it's Tom Cross's income tax. So we'll find out what he wants to do.
Does that mean that if it comes up in the Senate, it'll be all Democrats on it?
Oh, no. I think if we're going to have Tom voting for it, we'd have some Republicans vote for it as well. Remember, now we need 36 votes to pass it. So we had 31 votes the other day. So we're probably looking at least five Republicans in the Senate.
Would it have to come back?
Well, if it's the same one, no. If they vote for the same one we passed, then they only have to vote for that in the House. I'm talking about the possibility of them having a different form of an income tax. Mm-hmm. We have to have a balanced budget. We don't have, you could say we don't have a balanced budget now because there's, you'd otherwise have to cut $7 billion of things which are so essential that it's hard to call them bad. Now, there will be cuts, though. There's no question that we'll have further cuts. In addition to, I said that last night, even with our income tax, we were going to have to cut at least $2 billion out of a $28 billion budget.
Do you think the final solution will contain that billion-dollar expansion of the sales tax base that includes cable television and things like that?
Well, that's that passed one chamber, so I think that should be a consideration. And you can pick and choose some of those services. Those services represent laws in other states that surround us, and so and as I said on the floor, it helps the underlying base of the sales tax base because the service economy is growing, and so there's some things in there that might bother the Republicans, the fur storage and the charter jets and the yachts, but if we can work with them, maybe we can come up with a compromise and get some of those services and add some money. We were able to add $1 billion in income tonight by refinancing the debt and doing some more sweeps, so that will help as well.
As far as recall, why not have that read into the record a couple hours ago and then you could be finishing it off tonight?
I talked to the governor, he said call it when, it's a constitutional amendment that's not voted on until next year. Okay, so. And we're going to do it. It passed out of committee. It passed out of the House. It's not a trick. We're going to call it, I think, government. But I think the one thing, though, that we can say tonight is that we really have worked together. There hasn't been the fighting that we've seen in the last several years where, you get to midnight on the last day and people are screaming and yelling. We had very civil conversations, especially on the Capitol bill and even on areas where we disagreed. Campaign finance disclosure, I think it was done in a polite way. So I think that was accomplished. And
can you give us an idea how long you think this process is going to last with the leaders' meetings and coming back and voting?
I have no idea. I mean, it's up to, when I had these meetings earlier with Tom Cross and Christine, I said, we should do this before tonight. But they really acted as if they didn't want to talk until after midnight. So we'll find out what their agenda is now. It'll be up to them to decide how long they want to spend. We know we need an income tax increase of some sort. So the question is how much and what form they'll be.
Maybe somebody said this, but knowing the governor is going to sign the Capitol bill, has he told you that he will do that soon? And keep
we didn't discuss that. I mean, the let's put it this way: the Capitol bill passed overwhelmingly, beyond a veto-proof majority, so that even the taxes to do that. So I don't think there's much of an issue with the Capitol bill passing.
Has the Lang hold come off of that yet?
I'm sorry?
The Lou Lang hold?
Yeah, I don't know. That's over in the House, and obviously they have to pass it, the second appropriation bill tonight, so we'll find out. But I'm sure that was just a procedural thing to hold it up from going to the governor, but I'm sure that's, at this point in time, that's not going to be an issue.
Now, the recall amendment, do you expect to have that finalized when we call them back? his number one ethics priority, and that he probably would like to have that going into a campaign.
Yeah, we'll call it, my plan is to call it the next time we come back into session, that day. The first day we can physically call it, I'll call it.
What about fumigation? What happened with that?
We just ran out of time on that. And that's something that I want to make sure people understand. And there was some confusion. There were some Democrats speaking against it. I think there's some real confusion as to what it does. And I didn't want to rush into that until we make sure everybody understands what it is.
Is Speaker Madigan okay with that?
I haven't had a chance to tell him about that. The bill passed over unanimously in the House. But sometimes that happens. You know, bills pass unanimously, they go to the other House, and people have different questions about it. So. Okay. Good night. Thanks.
Hey, do you think that the